Hello guys, welcome again. In previous video, we have seen that how we can make a RESTful application in Spring Boot using list. In this video, I am going to modify the previous video output, the RESTful API application using list. In this video, I am going to use at the background MySQL, and for connectivity, I am using the Hibernate JPA. So first of all, I am just starting my MySQL from XAMPP. So the MySQL running on 3306 port. So first of all, I have to define the property of MySQL in application.property file, and then I will modify and remove the list also. So first of all, I am just using here spring dot data source dot URL, and the URL would be that JDBC MySQL localhost 3306 port number, and my database name is student info. Remember that I am using student info is a data name, database name. JDBC MySQL, you have to write all these things similarly as I am typing here. Then next one is username, data source dot username. So username is root, then spring dot data source dot password. Now password is blank, so I am not entering any password. Now the Java MySQL driver class, so spring dot data source dot driver class name, and we can say JDBC, sorry, we say com dot MySQL dot cj dot JDBC driver. So this class we want. This is for MySQL connectivity. Now what I need JPA setting. For that, spring dot JPA dot hibernate dot DLL auto update, we have to put here update. Then spring dot JPA dot show SQL, we have to say true. Then we have to set dialer also. So spring dot JPA dot properties dot hibernate dot dialect. Then we have to select the dialect, control shift and T we have to press. Here we have to write MySQL. So MySQL 57 dialect we have to select. So I need to type the same one. So I say hibernate dialect. DIALECT. Okay. So org dot hibernate dot dialect. Here also we have to change the spelling name dialect. Then we have to give the name, the same name which we have on that class. That name is control shift and T, that is MySQL 57 dialect. MySQL 57 dialect, same spelling, Y small capital small letter and SQL in capital letter, D capital. So same we have to put here as a dialect. That means is a mediator between the Spring Boot and the MySQL. So we have given the setting here, I save it. Now we have to go to controller. Controller is automatically ready here. So we have to change in the student class here, because I want to create a table in a MySQL on the basis of a student class. So I will put here entity. I will make this class as an entity. So this one I will use, and I will create this long as a primary key. So I will create as a ID like this. Now no need of constructor, so I have to remove this constructor. So this property is ready now. Now I have to go to interface, the same. Now I have to go to services. I have to remove the list because I don't want this list. I want JPA. I don't want this also. So I don't want constructor also for any reason. Now I have to modify the function those I am using here. So I am not using list. So one by one I will change the code. First of all, I have to make an interface that will work as a JPA mediator. So just right click, and I have to create here the interface. I'm giving here name is student DAO data access object, and that interface should be in the sub interface of JPA repository like this. Save this one, and I have to import the class, and here I have to pass the table name, that would be my student class, and I have to pass the prime data type of primary key. Remember that this class should be entity, because we have create here entity, and we have to pass the data type of the primary key. So here in student DAO I am passing long as a ID or a primary key as ID. Just save this one. Now my mediator, the dialer is connected, my interface is ready, data access object is ready to fetch the data from the MySQL using Hibernate. So I just close it, and I have to create here the object of this class. So I say student DAO like this, and I say SD student object, and because it should be created automatically, so I say auto wired. So having created the object of this, now this is get request. So get request, I want to fetch all the data, so I say SD dot find all. Remember that this function is automatically generated by the JPA, because we have created here the DAO class, and we have extend the interface this one. So automatically this class will be the, you can say, the mediator between this Spring Boot and the my application. So this particular class object will fetch all the data from the student table, and it will return in the list format. Now here we want to update some data, get data on the basis of SID. So I'm just removing this one. Now what I want, just remove all these setting, nothing doesn't require. I want to fetch on the basis of ID. So what I say here SD dot find, sorry, get by ID. And we will provide here the ID as a SID. So it will return the one record that I am passing as the ID. Doesn't require to write a single line of code. Each and everything is automatically generated by the JPA. So we are just fetching the information from the object which we have created from the interface. Means this data access object is responsible for all the data which we are fetching. Now for add student, that means the post request from this controller, which we are using here. In the previous video, I have explained you to create this. So this post data coming in add student, and here we have to save. For saving, I have to say sd dot save, and we are passing here student. So automatically this data will be inserted in this table. Now for update, doesn't need to write so much of code, just one line of code we have to write, that I have to write here sd dot save student. Remember that here also I have used the save, and here also I am using save, means for update and for add I am using the same method, because this method check if id is already present, if the record is already present, then the value will update, otherwise the value will add a new record. So here the value is already available, so it will update the record, and here because of the id is not available, so it will insert the record. Now what we have to do, we have to do for delete only. For deleting is a very simple, what we do, first of all just I get the record student s, and I get by sd dot get by id like this on the basis of sid, and then I use sd dot delete and I pass the s here, and after deleting I am passing the same record which have been deleted. So you see that with the help of JPA we have created all these, and we have using the inbuilt functions, those are available and those are provided by the JPA. Remember that, no need to use this one now, so just remove this, save already. Now everything is done, error is removed, so we have done this. Interface is there, we have done this one also, this one is also there, this one is also there, this one is there. Now we try to execute the code, because we have converted the same code in JPA. Now I try to run it. Now program is running properly, no error, and I have to open the MySQL. First of all I show you that I don't have any record, and I go to MySQL and bin, and here I just use cmd command prompt MySQL user root, then use database student info like this, and you see I have the show tables, I have this table, so I'm removing, drop table student. Okay, so now there is no table available here, we don't have any table, so we will do everything by using Hibernate. So now I am using, remember that no table is available, now I am using the postman for fetching data from the MySQL using Hibernate. So what I do, I just use same port number and I say get, and you will see that we will have the, I say get, I'm getting error, why, because I think it is not running so far, why it is not running, okay, once again I tried to execute it because I have deleted the table, that's why it's just doing the same thing. So I just restart it again, yes, done, Now again I am fetching the record, and you see the empty is coming here because the table was deleted earlier. So now we have the empty record, and I want to insert a record. So I will say post, and I will go to body. Under this I have a record, and I say send. It will delete, sorry, it will insert. You see this record have been inserted. Now once again I say to, and I give some more information like mtech, and I change the name Mr. Anil Kumar, and I say post. You see record inserted. If I want to check the record, just do get, and I have both record here. If one record I want to fetch, just click on this and send. You see one error is coming. This error comes because of the serialization problem in this Hibernate. For that, what I have to do, you see there is an error, serialization. This error come for serialization. For that I have alternative. Just I have to paste this line of code on my table, that is the class entity. In this class, in this student class, I have to say to my entity that all the serialization will be handled by the JPA. So JPA will handle all the serialization information. Just save it and restart again, relaunch the application. It is running. So this problem comes only when we use a single key, single, we pass some parameter and we want to fetch a single record. Again, if I try to fetch, you see the ID is coming 1, so in the same table I say 2, so second record is coming. If I don't pass any ID, then all 2 records will come. If I use the post and I want to insert the 3 one also, third one also, and I can change the name Sunil Kumar, just for example, third record have been inserted. If I use the get, you see all record are coming. And if I want to update, so I have to say put, and in place of this mtech, if I change btech for Sunil Kumar and I send, so you see information has been updated. And by using the ID number 3, I can check that btech has been changed to, sorry, we have to use get here and fetch here. You see the mtech has been converted to btech. Now I can fetch all the record also, all 3. Now if I want to delete, so just I have to use the delete one, and I have to pass the key. I say third, so 3 record will delete from this. It has been deleted. And now you see if I get, only 2 record will be available. You see 2 records are available. So all are working, get is working, put is working, post is working, delete is working, and get with serial ID, if I want to fetch one record, is also working. And if you say that I have delete the table, but after running the Hibernate, this table is generated automatically by the Hibernate. Same fields are coming, SID, course and name, matching from my class name. You see name, course and SID, and the record which I have inserted, that will be also same. You see the same 2 records are available, one have been deleted. So data is coming similar way as we have insert, but remember that here we are using JPA, and without just opening a MySQL, we have created the table also on the basis of class. We have registered the information, we have entered the information here by using get, put and post and delete. All are working here properly. So in previous video I used the list for data storage purpose, and here I am using the MySQL, and I have removed all the list, and in place of list I use this DAO data access object. Data access object I created with the help of JPA repository, and here I pass the table name, entity name and the type of the primary key, and on the basis of student DAO I just fetch all the information available to JPA. From the JPA, I just create this REST API application without any problem. You see, each and everything is running properly. So if you like this video, you have learned anything from this video, kindly do subscribe my channel, and thank you for watching this video.